Let's start with the easiest part of this video, the physical differences. They all have almost identical dimensions and weight, and even the internal cooling solution and fan setup are very similar. The M4 Pro, however, has an updated webcam with slightly better image quality and the new center stage technology that follows you around. Port selection is identical apart from the M4 Pro getting the new Thunderbolt 5 standard, which results in improved speeds and bandwidth. Thunderbolt 5 is mostly going to be beneficial for those who want to use multiple external monitors with 5K or above resolution. Speaking of screens, all of these MacBooks use the same mini LED liquid retina XDR displays. However, the M4 Pro's screen also gets significantly brighter than all other versions, up to 1000 nits, which is incredible for outdoor use. You can also pair this with the optional $150 nano texture display, giving the screen a matte coating that significantly reduces reflections and glare. Seriously consider this upgrade if you're frequently using your MacBook on the go and, you know, especially in locations that can get really bright. I found the matte display doesn't reduce contrast or sharpness noticeably versus the standard glossy panel. Now moving on to the chips inside each MacBook and how they compare. In this video, I'm comparing the base model Pro chips with no upgrades. Here's a comparison chart showing you the configuration of the base models in this video, and the number in brackets is the maximum possible configuration you can select. Just note that currently only the M4 Pro can be bought brand new from Apple, so it's the only one that you can fully customize. The M4 Pro has some noticeable improvements, particularly more CPU performance cores and 6 GB of additional unified memory over the previous M3 Pro. I also ran a speed test on all the base model internal 512 GB SSDs and found that with the exception of the M2 Pro, they were relatively similar and you almost certainly won't notice a difference. The M4 Pro also has the same media engines for video rendering and playback as the M3 Pro. It also gets all the same GPU specific upgrades like hardware accelerated ray tracing, mesh shading, and dynamic caching, where the M2 and M1 Pro do not. Now, one important difference here though is the memory bandwidth. Apple Silicon chips use unified memory. That is, all the RAM can be accessed by the CPU, GPU, and any programs currently running on the Mac. Where memory bandwidth is important is how fast this RAM can be accessed. The M4 Pro has significantly faster speeds than previous generations. In fact, it's 82% faster than the M3 Pro. Now, you won't notice this during everyday basic tasks, but when you're doing something intensive, think of it kind of like a highway. Cars, or pieces of data in this example, on the M4 Pro's highway have a speed limit almost twice as fast than that of the M3 Pro. And we'll see how this impacts performance later on. Now, speaking of impacts, imagine if this happened to your expensive new MacBook. Luckily, through the magic of editing, my MacBook is safe thanks to tomtoc's 360-degree protective laptop sleeve. And big thanks to tomtoc for supporting my channel and sponsoring this section of the video. Now, this 360-degree sleeve utilizes military-grade protection and high-density soft padding to protect your MacBook from knocks and bumps. For the butterfingered individuals among us, there's also this really cool corner armor technology that actually wraps around the edges of your MacBook to protect it from drops. On the inside, there's a soft inner lining, and the outside is made from durable and spill-resistant fabric, securely enclosing your MacBook with premium YKK zippers. The front also has a little storage pocket, perfect for accessories or even a charger, and there's a lanyard for an AirTag or keys. And you can pair your sleeve with a color-matched electronics organizer travel case, made from the same premium material and with tons of internal storage and organization. So check out the link in the description to upgrade your MacBook's protection and accessories organization today. Moving on, quick note here on just general everyday usability like multitasking, web browsing, or emails. I'm not gonna waste your time. All of these chips do this perfectly. You will not notice a difference. Okay, now it's time to look at some more intensive tasks. I mean, this is a pro computer after all. For CPU performance, on paper, the M4 Pro is significantly better than even the M3 Pro. The individual cores are faster and multi-core performance is a whopping 53% better. Although I found that real life performance really depends on the specific workflow. Sometimes I'd see roughly 50% better, but usually the difference was a little less pronounced, like around maybe 20 to 30% or so. If you're a programmer compiling code, for example, it means about a 3.5 minutes difference between a 2-year-old secondhand M2 Pro and a brand new M4 Pro. Regardless, the message is very clear here. If your workflow is CPU intensive, the M4 Pro is significantly better by a very wide margin. Taking a look at anything AI related, all of these chips have an NPU, or Neural Processing Unit, which Apple calls their Neural Engine. It's the part of the chip that looks after artificial intelligence and machine learning, and is also utilized by Apple Intelligence, which runs on your Mac. The M1 Pro gets smoked. The M2 and M3 Pro are comparable to each other, but the M4 Pro is the clear winner. Looking at creative workflows using the Adobe apps, there are improvements between each generation, but nothing too major unless you compare, you know, the M1 Pro with the latest M4 Pro. For video editing though, let's expand on that a little bit more, because you're going to be spending 95% of your time playing back footage or scrubbing timelines, and I couldn't tell a major difference between any of them, even with fairly demanding multicam timelines with color correction. And there's a simple explanation for this. It's because the media engines in these chips have similar hardware video encoders and decoders. So as long as you're using one of these supported codecs, which, you know, is the case 95% of the time, rendering and overall video editing performance difference will be minimal. However, once you move into more demanding areas like applying stabilization, for example, or rendering in a video codec that the media engine does not support, there will be differences. And anything effects or 3D related, like Fusion in DaVinci Resolve, for example, will noticeably benefit from the more powerful GPU on the M4 Pro. Moving on to some popular 3D workflows, the M4 Pro with its beefier GPU and faster memory bandwidth once again is significantly more powerful than the M3 Pro, but both it and the M3 Pro destroy the others because not only do they have the new hardware accelerated ray tracing technology, which the others do not, but this is also now supported in many apps, like Blender, which gained ray tracing capability in version 4. Now, remember, there are still some apps that don't support Apple Silicon ray tracing, and if that's the case, you're looking at results like this instead. Still pretty good, but ray tracing is clearly an improvement. Now, if you do any gaming, there's no huge difference between the M1, M2, and M3 Pro. The M4 Pro destroys all of them though, even in situations where the game does not support ray tracing. The M4 Pro is simply significantly more powerful and can just push more frames out. For battery life, overall I found the M3 Pro did technically perform the best, but you're honestly not going to notice, so I'm going to spare you all of the benchmarks and charts and stuff like that. All four MacBooks just have insane battery life. I mean, I get like 16 hours when doing light stuff like internet browsing, and it's not a fair comparison anyway, right? Like, any battery test I do now is with older and used MacBooks, like the 3-year-old M1 Pro, and all of them, with the exception of the brand new M4 Pro, will have varying levels of consumed batteries with less available capacity. So don't even consider battery life in your purchase decision. All of them are really good. So which one should you buy, or maybe upgrade to if you're on an M1 or M2 Pro? First of all, I think they're all great and you honestly can't go wrong. But unlike my last Pro chip comparison video where I was a little bit unimpressed with the M3 Pro, especially compared to the M2 Pro, it is different this time. I mean, before you even look at real life performance differences, the M4 Pro has an additional 8 GB of unified memory included for free over the M1 Pro and M2 Pro, and of course 6 GB for the M3 Pro. That right there is a huge upgrade just on its own. And then you add on the option of a matte screen, which I personally am going to choose from now on for my personal MacBook, more CPU performance cores that are also significantly faster, an improved GPU, and just like the CPU, with significant performance increases, and all of this is able to access the unified memory significantly faster than previous versions. It's just an instant like 30 to 50% boost depending on the workflow compared to the older versions, and you will notice it. Also, the M4 Pro will have warranty, the option to customize it to your exact configuration, and will receive software support for longer than the older models. Now, all of this being said, if this is going to be your first Pro MacBook, the older M2 Pro or M3 Pro MacBooks can be bought secondhand or refurbished for a significant discount over the M4 Pro. So if you can grab a lightly used M3 Pro, for example, for, you know, 30 to 40% less than a brand new M4 Pro, that's gonna rule out most of the M4 Pro's performance gains on a purely performance per dollar scale. But overall, I'm impressed, Apple. The M4 Pro is a beast, and if you are interested in my current MacBook Pro desk setup and some of the accessories I use, I'll link that video here for you to watch.